I present to you best ever okra curry recipe, really easy to make and super yum. For this recipe, you will need 750 grams of okra. You can use more or less depending on how much you have available and adjust the spices accordingly. So just wash the okra, then remove the end parts and then slit it into halves. So just cut it into halves, just like so, and get all the okra pieces ready. And then set them aside. You can see some of them are overripe. You can tell by the seeds. So you can choose to remove these seeds, or it might take a little longer to cook. So in a pan or in a wok, heat 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil. Once the oil is hot, add cumin seeds, 1/2 teaspoon, mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon, red chili powder, 1 teaspoon, and 1 teaspoon of turmeric. That's haldi, for that beautiful yellow color. Next, we are adding 4 tablespoons of chickpea flour. We call it besan. So chickpea flour is in, that is the ingredient that lends so much flavor to this dish. So roast your chickpea flour for a few minutes, 2 to 3 minutes, don't let it burn, low heat. Once it's done, 2 to 3 minutes over, add onions and then small chopped piece of ginger and garlic. I normally freeze ginger and garlic, buy it in bulk, cut it in pieces and freeze it so it's easy to use. And I'm going to roast everything here for another 2 to 3 minutes, mix well, and then add your okra, also called lady finger. So mix it well so that okra is well coated with all these spices, with chickpea flour, besan, onions. And then add 1 teaspoon of mango powder, that is amchur, that doesn't let okra get slimy. And then salt should be as per taste. I had added 1.5 teaspoon for this recipe. Mix it well and then cover the pan or wok and let everything cook for 3-4 minutes. Once it's a little soft, then you add your tomatoes, 2 small chopped tomatoes here. You can also use tomato puree, or you can simply blend these tomatoes, add that in, mix well and cover the pot again. Give another 4-5 minutes so that tomatoes are done. And depending on the freshness of your okra, it will be 5 to 7 minutes. You finish it off by adding garam masala and garnish it with cilantro leaves. And that's it. Once your okra is nice and tender, you know it's done. Then you serve it with flatbread of your choice. Hope you like the recipe. Please share it with others. And thank you for watching Eat East Indian channel.